गुड आफ्टरनून, आई एम वृशाली धनोकार, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट इन ASMS IOIT पुणे. सो हियर इन टुडे सेशन वी विल लर्न अबाउट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इन मशीन लर्निंग, दैट इज ओवरफिटिंग वर्सेस अंडरफिटिंग एंड बायस वर्सेस वेरियंस. सो लेट्स सी. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट कंसेप्ट इन मशीन लर्निंग, दैट इज व्हाट इज ओवरफिटिंग. So, the chances of occurrences of overfitting increase as much as we provide the training to our model, okay? So, means more we train our model, so more chances of occurring overfitted model is there. So, overfitting is a main problem occurrence in supervised learning. So, simply see here in this diagram, there are so many data points are present. These green color points are called as data points, okay? So, what is the concept of what is the concept of regression? Regression concept is try to cover all the points on data points, try to cover all the data points in single one line. Okay, so here training is not properly done. See here, they try to cover all the points but not in straight line, right? So this is a concept of overfitting. So as we can see this graph, model try to cover all the data points present in the scatter plot, right? But it may look efficient, but in reality it's not so, because goal of regression model is to find out the best fit line. You need to find out a straight line, right? So we have not got the best fit line here, so it generated the errors. So this is a concept of overfitting. Now see here in underfitting, what is the concept of underfitting? In this case of underfitting, model is not able to learn enough from the training data. Okay, see here, there are so many data points are present in this graph. Okay, and you need to find out the best fit line, but this is the best fit line, this is a straight line, this is okay, but they can't cover multiple data points into the one single line because all the points are present in scatterly in this particular graph. So this is a underfitted model which has high bias and low variance and reduced the accuracy and also produced unreliable prediction. So as we can see from the above diagram, model is unable to capture the data points present in the plot. So this is the concept of underfitting. So overfitting and underfitting, these are the errors are present in machine learning. So due to avoid for this underfitting, you need to increase the training time of model, or you need to increase the number of features. That's why if machine can be properly trained, so this kind of errors didn't occur. Now see here, this is just representation of overfitting and underfitting and good balance. See here in overfitting, it cover all the points but not in straight line. So this error is occur overfitting. In underfitting, the straight line is here but they didn't cover all the points, right? This is underfitting. So what is the good balance? The good balance is this. See here, there is a curve line is present and they try to cover all the points, data points in the particular graph. So this is a good balance. And overfitting and underfitting, this kind of errors are occur in machine learning. So try to train the machine properly by using appropriate and relevant features. Now the next concept is bias versus variance. So in machine learning, bias means the gap between actual value of model and predicted value of data, and variance means prediction value, how much scatter with relationship between the each other. So simply just see here in this diagram, I will explain through the diagram. Bias has two types, high bias and low bias. High bias means predicted value is more far away than actual value, and low bias means predicted value near to actual value. Okay. And variance again has two types, low variance and high variance. Low variance means group does not scatter with each other, group of predicted data. And high variance means scatter with each other. Okay. Now see here in this diagram, there is a low bias and low variance in the first diagram. So low bias and low variance, this is the accurate condition. See here, low bias means predicted value is near to actual value, right? This brown color dots are the actual point. And this blue color dots are called the predicted value. So predicted value is near to actual value. So this is accurate, right? So this is a low bias. And low variance means group of predicted value. See here, all the blue color dots are present one with each other. So this is a group of predicted value is there. So low bias and low variance means accurate data. The next is low bias and high variance. See here, low bias means predicted values near to actual value. See here, all the blue color data points are somewhat near to the actual value, that is this brown color dot. But high variance means all the points are scattered with each other. The next, high bias and low variance. See here, high bias means predicted value is far away from actual value. There is a lot of distance between this, right? And low variance means group of predicted data. And on the opposite, high bias and high variance. So high bias means predicted value is far away from actual value. See here. And high variance is there, means all the points are scattered with each other, right? So this is a low concept of bias versus variance. So which one is best? Low bias, low variance. So this is the comparisons. If low bias and low variance are there, means this is the ideal scenario. Your model is consistent and accurate on an average, and this is the target of machine learning model. But if there is a high bias, high variance are there, means your model is inconsistent and inaccurate. Low variance and high bias means your model is consistent but low on average, and high variance and low bias means somewhat accurate but inconsistent on an average, according to this diagram. Okay, so which one is best? Low variance and low bias means it generates the 90% or more than 90% accuracy in your model. So this is all about bias, variance, overfitting and underfitting. Thank you.